So, you're a non-technical person. You're from biology or mechanical engineering or social sciences, and you want to get into code. So far, everyone around you has told you that code is bad, but you've been on Twitter and you've been seeing that the salaries for coders have been crossing, you know, crazy mind-boggling numbers, and now you're interested. You know, one thing I like about people making money, whether it be in crypto or code, is that it actually brings attention to that field. And now that there's so much attention in this field, both positive attention with the kind of money that people are making and negative attention with things like White Hat Junior, right? And the ads they're kind of running. I actually wanted to get into a very specific question, which is how can non-technical people learn code? We have Tanay, who's a SDE2, a software engineer, a senior software engineer at Microsoft, here to answer the question for us. Tanay, how can a non-technical person start coding?
Hey, anyone from the production, right? If I ask you how to make tea and give that in like four instructions, can you do that?
Yeah.
Okay, tell me.
So step one will be to get the vessels.
Okay, get the vessels.
Step two will be to switch on the gas and put on top.
Okay.
Step three will put the water and heat it.
Okay.
Step four will be to put sugar and tea powder.
Awesome. So you can code, no? If you can tell instructions of how to do something, you can code. Now you have to tell these instructions to a computer. Similar English language, it's just the syntax is a little bit of a problem, but thinking is the same. You can code, you just need to tell computer how to do stuff.
So you're saying people are missing the syntax, but they already know inherently how to code. We already know how to do things, we do it in order.
True.
We just need to tell a computer how to do this, and we are missing how to tell the words.
True.
But what about the frustration? If it was this simple as you're making it out to be, what about the frustration that a lot of people go through the first time they open up and try to do C++ or Java or JavaScript?
And the frustration is because if I ask you how to make tea and you can make tea, but if I ask you how to drive a car and if you don't know how to drive a car, there are two problems now. You don't know how to interface with a car and you also don't have that innate skill. So if you try to tackle a very tough problem in the first go, you will feel like, you know, coding is not my cup of tea. That's why I keep telling people, start with the most basic problems. Because I started coding 15 years back, I started coding like that. Star pattern, print star patterns, you know. Add two numbers, tell me a prime number or not. If I ask you, how do you calculate prime number? You know it inside your head, right? This is how I calculate prime numbers. So start with basic problems. But the problem is, whenever you go to a big course or somewhere, you generally get content wherein they assume you know programming, and still they would say it's for non-technical people, but it's not like that. And this problem I have solved. Like if you see my video on how to get started programming, 50,000 people have watched and started it, because that's a very small quiz I have asked them to code. Take a question, check the answer, which is very easy, right? You can write your own quiz, something like that. So start easy.
Yeah. So, you know, I was talking to Elson about this, right? Someone from my team about this, and he was like, he's a non-technical person. He's been trying how to code. He's been learning it. So his question was, it's just too frustrating. Simple problems are easy to solve. I can print a hello world, right? And I can understand the syntax for that. But how do I make a game? How do I make Star Wars? How do I, make the next Swiggy?
Awesome.
Right? Those are difficult questions. And it seems like the leap between hello world to making Swiggy is like massive.
True.
So how do you go from there to there? Do you also feel the same frustration?
Yes, if you ask me today to write a driver for a fridge, right? I don't know how to do systems programming, so I don't know anything about it. I have to start from zero. So whenever, it's like when you were born, it took you 3 years just to say your first words, and then it took you so many years to do whatever you are doing. And 4 years into this having a car, I still don't know how to drive a car. So it's tough. Life is tough. If complex things are complex because they are complex, right? But you have to start from somewhere and make on top of it. You say hello world, then you do if or else, right? If someone is asking for tomato, tell them the price is 12 rupees. If someone is asking for potato, tell them the price is 100 rupees. Say now if else is completed, now you get into for loop. So you have to build your building blocks, your Lego blocks, and then it won't be frustrating.
Got it. So you're saying that people are going for the planet when they should be building the bricks first.
Exactly.
Got it. So, I kind of put this slightly differently, right? I was teaching some kids Unreal programming, and we started with blueprints. So the advantage with visual programming is that I don't have to teach them syntax.
True.
So they just have the nodes, they figure out which node they have to use, they connect it. It becomes so simple. Because now you can focus on the concepts. And things like classes, you can easily get into because you can visually see what a class is. You can just pull a chair into the scene and say, okay, this is an actual chair.
True.
And I can make many of these chairs, right? And I can make a chair that's green color and I can show them many more concepts of code. But one way I've learned to kind of pitch this to students who are frustrated, think of it like you're a cook. It's the same as cooking or being a chef, okay? You don't know how to start the gas. But once you know how to start the gas, you know, turn on the gas, press the lighter, now you have a skill, you have a permanent skill you acquired. Now that you have this permanent skill, everything else builds on top of this. So similarly, learning basic syntax is a skill. Once you have this, you can build on top of this. Then there's another layer of building stuff on top. For example, if you know how to put oil on the gas, right? And if you know how to heat that, now you know, or maybe you know, you've learned how to put omelets on it or pancake or dosa and you've learned how to flip it. That's a skill. Because whether it's dosa or pancakes or omelets, it's the same skill of flipping, right? So now you've learned that flipping skill. You know exactly how much oil is required. You know exactly when to flip. You know exactly when something is burning. So you know all the edge cases. That's a permanent skill. Now, if you're making a full meal, you know how to make one part of the meal. So I feel like people don't understand that coding is about severe compounding. It's like there's compounding in the finance world. Compounding in coding is even bigger, right? Suddenly you're here. It's like the COVID, right? Like it's like the coronavirus. You start with 2, suddenly you're at 4. It's not a big deal, right? 2 to 4, not a big deal. 4 to 8, not a big deal. 8 to 16, not a big deal. 16 to 32, not a big deal. 32 to 64, not a big deal. But as you keep going, the minute you hit like 20, 30 iterations, you're in the millions,
yep.
Right? Because that's how compounding works. And that's also how compounding works in code.
Completely agree. I don't know how to flip, by the way. But I want to say this, right? Nobody was born a coder. Like people say, how can a non-technical person get into coding?
But everyone's a non-technical.
Everyone's non-technical. Nothing, koi aisa badna chyawanprash I didn't eat, right? Which taught me how to code. So you have to start somewhere, and then compounding idea is really nice because now I can think in if else. I don't have to think about if else. I have to think about systems, right? But that came from 15 years of practice. It can come to you in 6 months or 1 year of practice itself.
And it changes the way you think, right? This is not a coding related example, but when my wife learned design, she started seeing everything in terms of design. So when she'd go to a random place, she'd see something and she'd be like, oh, this looks like the liquify filter, right? And that's a word that she's learned because she was using the liquify filter in Photoshop at that time, many years ago, right? So you start thinking in those terms, you start seeing life in those terms. You'll start seeing life in terms of if else. You start seeing life in terms of loops. That's why a lot of people who start coding after a year or so, they start thinking about the simulation theory. Because they realize, hey, if you apply code to life in general, that becomes simulation, right? And then you can go even further. But the point is, for a non-technical person to get into the technical side, to get into code, you just have to start. You have to understand that it takes a little bit of frustration in the first few weeks. And it's normal even for experts.
Frustration is real. The thing you need to find out is a community which is frustrating with you, right? That's why when you go to school and everybody's struggling with drawing, you're like, yeah, nobody knows I'm also fine. So go to a school where everyone's struggling. If you hang out with experts, you'll always feel I'm not doing enough, I'm not learning fast enough.
So Tanay, you know, one more thing, right? And this is something that students often tell me is like, Varun, I'm really frustrated, you know, typing int, void. I can't remember all that. It's too frustrating. In fact, I know how to do the instructions. I want to give computer instructions. It's this int, void, public, whatever that's annoying me. How do I get beyond that?
I think you just need to accept it for some time and then it becomes very easy. You don't have to do much. And this is like we're playing video games, right? If I play a video game and I suck at it, I have to remember all the keys. Okay, this is A, this is B, this is F.
Jump is A.
This is roll, there are mixes this is of these like five keys and this is that punch. I don't know gaming, by the way. You can see how bad I am. So I will struggle there. But once I have understood the console, then it just flows. Then you don't think about keys in your head. It just translates, right? So you have to give some time for that. If it was easy, everybody would be doing it. And then people wouldn't be getting 20 lakh, 30 lakh rupees as a fresher salary these days. Yeah. So it's not easy. So it takes some time and that's the only way to do it.
Yeah. No, that's what I tell my students also, right? If the ints and the voids and the publics and whatever frustrate you, just spend 3 hours a day with the editor open. Don't do anything. Just keep it open for 2 weeks. Because you're going to get bored, okay? I know you guys, you want to scroll Instagram, whatever. Switch off your phone, keep it away. Open the editor, open Visual Studio, okay? And just stare at it. After the first half an hour, 20 minutes, you're going to get bored. You'll be like, okay, let me try this. Let me try the first few lines. Let me see what happens. You do that for 7 days, you do that for 14 days, you're done. Then you're familiar. Once familiarity and comfort with the editor sets in, then that's the path to you making those 30 lakhs, 40 lakhs. And by the way, I think even 30 lakhs, 40 lakhs are like small numbers for senior React Native developers today. We're hiring some senior guys. It's like, yeah, it costs
senior
a lot.
You get paid 50 lakhs to 1 CR easily. But even for fresher, if you don't know coding and you want to learn coding, in 6 to 12 months, you can go to 6 to 12 lakhs or even 20 lakh packages.
Yeah.
If you are good. So it there is a lot of money because it's difficult.
But I think the financial incentive, like, you shouldn't learn to code just because there's money inside it. You will never succeed.
True.
You need to learn to code because you truly enjoy it. Money is a side effect. And you'll realize all the best professions in the world, money is a side effect. If you do something just for money, right, you're going to burn out very quickly.
True.
You need to do something where you enjoy doing it. You enjoy solving a hard problem. And you might think, oh, maybe I don't enjoy solving hard problems. That's wrong, right? Because I know you enjoy solving hard problems. You've done it in the past before. When you drive, if many of you have driven, you're solving a hard problem constantly. You're figuring out which turn to take, right? Should I take the flyover? Should I not take the flyover, right? Sometimes you're looking at instructions on Google Map and following that.
And parking.
Parking, right? You're anyway solving hard problems. It's similar here,
true.
Right? So I feel like just get used to it. Right?
I think you have to think of it as game, right? It's tough at the beginning. Then you cross bosses. It's getting tougher and you're enjoying it. You're not, like, nobody's paying you to play something wherein you have to put so much hours and your mind, and it's getting tougher because you enjoy this, and that's how I think gamers are the best programmers, by the way.
Exactly.
I
Elon Musk started with a game called Blastar, And even today SpaceX tends to hire a lot more gamers than traditional people.
So I think coding should be taken as gaming. It's tough, but you have to enjoy it. You have to be familiar with the.
And one suggestion, if you're young enough, is start early. I know White Hat Juniors demonize this, but did you know that you can't train a gymnast? You can't train a gymnast to be an Olympian level gymnast if they start above the age of 10 years old.
Oh, I didn't know.
Their body just doesn't become flexible enough.
So what's your age? Like, what do you think? I think 15 to 17 is a good enough age.
I think you should start at 10.
10? Huh?
Yeah. And it doesn't need to be, bro, build the next Swiggy. It can be, bro, build a game that you enjoy. Like when I was some 13, 14 years, I started with a game engine called Mugen.
Okay.
People don't know this. A very niche game engine. Basically, you can take any characters and make them fight with each other. You can make Superman fight Goku, right? It's a cool game. And eventually, I wanted to make a character. And they have a particular scripting language. And it was a very simple intro for me to game development. I didn't even want to develop a game. I just wanted to create a character that beats up other characters that has a lot of powers. So I actually made my brother. His name is Rohan. So I actually made Rohan, and Rohan could kill Superman with one move, right? I was just having fun. But that started my journey. Right, and I feel that should be the initial aim for kids, rather than saying you have to learn code and you have to build the next app because you have to raise money or you have to go out and, you know,
yeah, man, have fun,
make 50 money. Lakhs.
Money is, I think, a consequence of you being good, and you become good in something when you enjoy it every day, and you will enjoy coding. Coding is not frustrating. I know I can say this after 15 years of doing it, but even the first time when I did, I like, oh, this is challenging. How can I talk to computers? It's about talking to computers and someone is doing your bit. You feel like, God, hey, do this, do that. And thousands of computers.
But I had a different experience. My first 2 weeks were frustrating. But beyond that, it gets easier. Because first 2 weeks, it's something new, right? You're getting used to it.
So for me, that worked. And my teacher, no, Nilanjan sir, he was really nice. So he taught me like this, like smaller programs, very small programs. Like, don't aim big. You will one day become big, but start with the smallest of the programs. So that was very helpful.
Do the first few kicks to the goal before you do the 360 and then...
Exactly. You have to start small. I think that's where a lot of people get frustrated with programming.
Yeah. No, makes sense. Thank you for tuning in. And if you're somebody who's non-technical and want to get into code, Tanay is a great person to follow. Links will be below. Bye!